I'm Jamie Kitchen, Training Manager with Danfoss. In this video, we're going to do a brief overview and introduction of the Danfoss Optyma Controller. So here you can see the Danfoss Optyma Controller as it would first look when you take it out of the box. On the front, you have your panel that will have the numbers for values, as well as the buttons on the front here that you'll use for changing these values and selecting different inputs. Along the bottom, you can see some of these we've already opened up, but you have opening access here for the conduit, the wiring, etc., and your communication cables as needed. Now, to get inside the controller, just remove these little side panels here. Now, they can be a little bit tight when it's brand new, but they just basically lift up and pop off. And they're interchangeable, by the way. They're both identical, so there's no order to them. And then just release these little locking screws here, which essentially just turn 90 degrees counterclockwise, allowing the lid to swing open, showing the inside. Once you get access to the inside, you'll notice there's a gray panel here that would have a screw there that needs to be removed. I've already removed this screw just to save time, but this then lifts off and you can see the circuit board inside. This contains all of the relays and connections that are required to power the various components that you're going to use with this controller. Things like the compressor, the solenoid relays for pump down, hot gas, you name it, these can all be controlled from here. Thank you for watching our video. For more information on the Danfoss Optyma Controller, please visit the link in the description below.